My name is Rosanna Flema Caldera. I'm 64 years old, and I identify as a woman, a cis woman, and a lesbian. Well, you know, the word lesbian, that's the issue. I realized I was different when I was about 5 or 6 years of age. I just couldn't articulate what that difference was. So I only started realizing from a very young age that being a lesbian is something dirty, something sordid, these kinds of things. So for a long time, I couldn't even say the word lesbian because it made me feel really awful inside. But I guess once I came out, then it was much easier for me to say lesbian and be proud of it and own it, yeah? Well, I came out to my family when I was 18. I think my friends, quite a few of them already knew what I was and who I was, even though I didn't know who I was at that time. But yeah, around about the age of 18, 19, when I came out, yeah. Well, my family was fabulous. They still are fabulous. My parents were extremely supportive. And my friends, well, if they didn't like it, then they were no longer my friends. But actually, I didn't disown any of my friends. So that shows that those friends, all of them, were true friends and realized that I was just different and I'm still the same person I am, the person that they knew before I came out. Well, I remember a friend of mine, well, I think a boyfriend of mine, wanting to make out with me, and I kept saying, no, that's not something I want to do right now. And then he called me a lesbian and I'm going like, what? What are you talking about? And that was when I was like 14 or 15, you know? So that was a difficult thing for me to sort of hear. But it's also very typical of a young male to say something ridiculously stupid just because he couldn't go to first base with a woman. You know, I really don't take that as much of a challenge. But yeah, it was a bit disturbing to suddenly realize that, yes, he may be right, you know? So yeah, myself. Yeah, it was very difficult to go to anybody else to talk about that. And you know, if you talk about homophobia, it's an ongoing thing. You know, I mean, even now, grown up, 64 years of age, still face, you know, homophobia on a daily basis. So you know, you just learn to deal with it. Well, you know, it was a long journey. I immigrated to the States when I was like 17. At that time, I really didn't know what I was, who I was. But going to San Francisco, where I lived for 15 years, was a huge eye-opener for me. I think it was a time when there was a lot of activism in San Francisco, led by Harvey Milk. For example, I was very privileged and you know, thankful that I was there at a time when, you know, the great Harvey Milk was at his prime. Unfortunately, he was assassinated, but it was something that resonated with me right throughout the 80s during the AIDS crisis. The number of you know, protests and marches that we attended. I didn't consider myself an activist at that time, but as a member of the LGBT community, you felt compelled to be involved in those kinds of you know, what should I say, types of activism, like, you know, joining a march, being in the Pride Parade, these kinds of things. And when I came home in the 90s, I wasn't thinking of being an activist or anything until I found out, and so much later in my life, that it was still a criminal offense to be engaged in same-sex loving relationships. And it was like, what? I didn't even know this. And that just goes to show that a lot of people in Sri Lanka really don't know what the laws are. I mean, I had lived like 30, 40 years of my life being absolutely clueless that there was such a law in Sri Lanka. And that made me angry, you know. It made me angry because I thought, how can you criminalize something so beautiful as love, yeah? And that's how I got involved with activism. It was kind of like, came to me sort of like just on the fly. Somebody asked me, hey, we're planning to maybe get a group of lesbian women together. Are you interested? I said, hell yeah, I'm interested. let's do it. And then we formed the women's support group for lesbian, bisexual women and transgender men. And then 4 years later, I decided that there was a huge gap in activism in Sri Lanka because it was very one-sided. You know, it was either very male-centric or female-centric. There was nothing in between. So I decided that, you know, we needed an organization that would basically include everybody, the entire alphabet, if you care to think of it that way. And also target our interventions, because one of the things that we felt was really lacking was the knowledge within the LGBTIQ community about themselves. They had all these connotations of who they were. Mostly they were ashamed of themselves. Mostly they were afraid to be out. Mostly they were, you know, thinking that there's something wrong with them. Just like what I went through growing up, you know, being told that it's wrong to be, you know, gay or lesbian. And needless to say, I left the Catholic Church at an early age because I was really not amused by the way they, you know, conducted themselves. Anyway, I'm anti-religion, I'm an atheist and I don't believe in religion. I don't believe in institutionalized religions, which actually form the nucleus of hate within this world. Well, you know, the only advice I can give them is to stay strong and to believe in themselves, because no matter what people tell you, that it's wrong to be LGBT, that you're a pervert, that you're this, that you're that, you know in your heart who you are and what you are. Stay true to that and make sure that you are proud of yourself no matter what other people tell you. And it doesn't matter whether you're LGBT, straight, of a minority community, whatever. I think that same thing applies, you know, to every single person. We see the world around us right now and it's there's a lot of strife. Hopefully that will pass, but it also just makes us just step back and realize, you know, that it's not about just being black or from a different ethnic community or whatever. In different parts of the world, there is all kinds of phobia, homophobia, phobia against, you know, persons of color, phobia against persons of different faiths, phobia about a lot of things. We need to stand strong, but before we do that, we need to be strong within ourselves. We need to be sure we are who we are. There's nothing going to change that, and there's nothing wrong with who we are. So stand tall, stand proud, and stand firm. Support equality.